We have our data ready to save, but there is one last thing we need to do before we start saving our graph, and that's allowing the removal of choices from our multiple choice nodes. Right now, we can add as many choices as we'd want, but there is no way for us to remove any of them. We'll also be updating the choices list data accordingly. Let's start this off by swapping our node choices type with the choice saved data we've created previously. So go to our DSNode script, and inside swap the string type from the choices list with the choice saved data instead. Of course, don't forget to import the data.save namespace for this class to be recognized. Swap it in our list initialization as well. This will allow us to save the connected nodes and the text of the choice in our node choices list. Note that our single and multiple choice node scripts also use this variable, so you'll need to update them to use a new type as well. So go to our DS single choice node script and start by importing the data.save namespace. Then, in its initialize method, create a new variable of type dsChoiceSaveData, which I'll name ChoiceData, and call its constructor. I'll use the object initializer here to pass in the text of next dialog. When that's done, pass in ChoiceData to the choices.add method instead of the string it currently has. Then swap the draw method string type from the forEach loop to be dsChoiceSaveData as well. And pass in choice.text to the createPort method. Now in our DS multiple choice node script, do the same in our initialize method after importing the data.save namespace. So simply create a new variable of type dsChoiceSaveData, set its text to be new choice, and pass the variable to the add method. In the draw method, in our add choice button, we'll have to create a new choice data too, so simply copy the code above and paste it here. Remove the last add method, and then pass in choiceData.text to the createChoicePort method. In our output container for each loop, swap the string with dsChoiceSaveData and pass in choice.text to the createChoicePort method as well. We can now start deleting our choices. We'll be doing that in our delete choice button in the createChoicePort method by giving it a callback. So pass in an empty parameter callback and inside we'll start by removing our choice. What we'll need to do is quite simple. If there is more than one choice, we can press on this button to remove the choice. The if is there because I want to always have a minimum of one choice per node. Because if we didn't want custom choices, we could simply make it a single choice node. If the choice port is connected, then we need to disconnect it, which will remove the edge from the graph. To finalize it, we'll need to remove the port from the graph itself. So in our callback, start by typing in if choices.count equals equals 1 and return if that's the case. With this, if there is more than one choice, we can remove that choice. Next, let's remove our connections if our choice port is connected. So type in if choiceport.connected, then we can remove the connections. However, we'll need the graphview variable here, which we only have in our DSNode script, as it's a private variable. So let's go back to our DSNode script and make the graphview variable be protected instead of private. With this, all classes that inherit from the DSNode class have access to this variable. So back in our multiple choice node, pass in graphview.deleteElements and pass in choiceport.connections. This will remove any connections this port has. We can now remove our choice from the choices list and the port from the graphview. However, we don't really have anything here that allows us to know what choices element we need to remove. What we'll do is quite simple. We'll simply pass in our choice data to the method and remove it. However, we'll do that by using the port userData variable. The userData variable is simply a variable in the port class that allows us to give it any data. This means that once we pass it in, we can get the choice data from any script as long as we have access to the port. This will be useful for us in a bit when setting the choice node ID. So instead of having a string with the text of the choice as a parameter, simply pass in a parameter of type object and name it userData. Then right under the choicePort declaration, type in choicePort.userData equals to userData. Under that, create a new variable of type dschoiceSaveData, to which I'll name choiceData, and assign the userData parameter to it, casting it into dschoiceSaveData. With this, we now have access to our choiceData variable. Of course, make sure you now pass in the choiceData when we call this method instead of the text. When that's done, back in our method, update the old string usage to be choiceData.text instead. All that's left now is to remove the choiceData from the choices list and the port from the graph. So in our delete button callback, type in choices.remove and pass in choiceData. Right under that, type in graphview.removeElement and pass in choiceport. Go to the single choice node script and pass in the for each choice variable to the choiceport.userData variable as well. If we save and go back to Unity, we shall now be able to remove our choices. The edges or port connections shall also be deleted when a choice is removed. However, there is one thing we still need to do. Whenever we create an edge or a connection between a choice and another, we should update the output choice data and set its node ID to be the ID of the node it got connected with. We should also remove that ID whenever we remove that edge or disconnect the choices. The way we'll be doing that is by overriding the graphViewChanged callback. So let's go to our dsGraphView script to the bottom of our callbacks region. We can make it in two different ways. The first one is by creating a method that accepts and returns a variable of type graphViewChanged. This class holds certain variables that we'll need. Then we simply set the callback to be that method, which has whatever code we want in it. The second one is what we've done so far. We simply override the callback with the necessary parameters. This is what we have used in all of our other callbacks. We'll be going with the second one. So create a new private method that I'll name onGraphViewChanged. And inside type in graphViewChanged and override the callback. This callback accepts one parameter which are the graphViewChanges, so I'll name it changes. This callback requires the parameter variable to be returned, so make sure you type in return changes at the bottom. We'll be making use of two variables here. The edgesToCreate variable, which will allow us to go through each edge that we have created, get its port and set its node ID. And then the elementsToRemove variable, which will allow us to go through every element we have removed from the graph, get the ones that are of type edge, get their port and remove their node ID. So let's start by going through our edgesToCreate list. So type in if changes.edgeToCreate different than null. And this is simply so that we do not iterate through a list if there are no elements on it. In here, we loop through our list by typing in for each edge in changes.edgeToCreate. And inside, we'll need to get the next node and the output port choice data. Thankfully, we can very easily do that with the edge variable. This is because the edge class has an input and output variable which gets the input and output port of that edge. Besides that, the port class also has a node variable, which gets the node that the port belongs to. So type in dsNode and we'll be getting the next node. So equals to edge.input to get the port.node. Of course, don't forget to cast it to our dsNode. Remember that the input port is the port that the choices will connect to. Then we need to get the choice data of the output port, as we don't really care about the output node. So type in dschoiceSaveData and make sure you import its namespace. and I'll name it choice data. Then assign the edge.output.userData variable to it and cast it to the edgeChoiceSaveData. This will get the choice data we've passed in when we created our choice port. When that's done, we have all we need, so type in choicedata.nodeID and assign the next node.id value to it. Our node choices list will also be updated because the choice data is referencing to that list element. To remove the node ID, it will be quite familiar. However, because it is elements to remove and not edges to remove, we'll need to check if the type of the element is of edge type. So type in just under our if statement, if changes.elementsToRemove different than null. We'll start by creating a variable of type type, which I'll name edge type, and assign the value of type of edge to it. Then iterate to the list by typing in for each graph element, element in changes.elementsToRemove, and if the type is not edge type, we continue. So if element.getType different than edge type, we continue to the next element. If it is of type edge, we need to get the edge through casting the element, so type in edge equals to element and cast it to edge. We can now get our choice data through the edge output port variable, so type in dschoiceSaveData and I'll name it choice data equals to edge.output.userData. Don't forget to cast it. To remove the node ID, we simply type in choicedata.nodeID equals to an empty string. Unless I've attempted it wrong, using the remove element in an edge, in our delete selection callback didn't add the edge to the elements to remove list. Because we are using the delete elements there, removing an edge from the graph will also add it to the elements to remove list, which means the node ID will also reset. Of course, don't forget to call this method in our constructor for the callback to get overrided. With this done, we should be able to remove all of our choices, except the last one, and our node ID should be set. There is still one thing left to do though, and that's updating the choice data text whenever we update the text field. Thankfully, this is pretty straightforward, so go back to our dsMultipleChoiceNode script, and in our CreateChoicePort method, we'll be adding a callback to our choiceTextField variable. So pass in null for the label, and then pass in a callback which I'll name callback. Inside, simply type in choicedata.text equals to callback.newValue. Our choicedata text should now be updating every time we type something in our text field. With that done, we now have everything we need for our choices.